Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or to my channel if you're new here. My name is Lily and welcome to my first college day of my life, first sophomore year of college. I'm so excited to be vlogging for you guys. I have not vlogged since I moved in and it's been so crazy and I've been so busy the past few days just getting settled in and everything like that and getting organized for school, but I did want to vlog the first day for you guys, especially because this first day of school is going to be different than any first day of school I've ever had, as I'm sure it is the same for a lot of you guys. So it is kind of confusing, but I am on campus. I am living in an apartment on campus in the upperclassmen side. And basically I have three classes that are technically meeting in person. One is supposed to meet fully in person, and then two of them are like rotational attendance, which means I will go once a week to these classes. But today is Monday, August 17th, and for the first day, all of my classes are meeting online. So I think they're just doing that because they don't have too much to say and it's just easier to do it online than to make everyone come into class. I'm meeting on a Microsoft team meeting for two of my classes, and then my third class today that I would normally have just isn't meeting online. I'm pretty sure everything is just like pre-recorded lectures and assignments that I have to do on my own, which I'm pretty nervous about. So it's gonna be interesting, but I just wanted to kind of explain to you guys what's going on for the day. So the three classes that I have today are Functional Anatomy and Physiology, I think is the name of it. It is a class that I have to take for my public health class. And then along with that, there's also a Writing and Analysis class, which is only a 2-hour credit class, but it is a class that I have to take in order to take other classes for my major. So it's like a prereq. So I have to take that class. And then my other class that I'm taking that I would normally have today is US History since 1877. But like I said, I don't technically have to meet online for anything for that class. So I just kind of am going to look on the syllabus and stuff like that and figure out what all I need to do. Yesterday I actually spent like 2 hours writing my planner and going through all the syllabuses or syllabi, whatever it is, for all my classes. And today I plan on going to the library and printing off everything. We don't have a printer here. I think I might have one that I can bring from home, but for right now I'm just going to use the library. So I'm going to go and get the syllabi for all my classes and like highlight stuff, because it's just a lot easier for me to have it on paper and just to be able to hands-on write it. And I wrote a lot of notes down about each class, but I just would feel better having the syllabus in front of me. So I did write down a lot of the stuff that I know I need to be prepared for my history class, because there's a lot of assignments online and a lot of just like activities I'm gonna have to do to get credit for things. But I just want to make sure that I have everything and I know what I'm doing. So that is kind of a rundown for the day. Sorry this was a long intro, but it's just gonna be a weird school year, weird semester, and definitely a different first day of school, but I'm still gonna vlog it for you guys because I think it'll be fun to look back on. So it is 7:58 right now. I'm about to go into the kitchen and make some breakfast. I have to log into my first class in a little over an hour, so we're gonna go get breakfast and then get ready. This is breakfast. You guys already know nothing has changed. I'm gonna take this outside because we have a balcony and I'm gonna go eat out there with my roommate. Pausing this real quick so I don't get copyrighted, but I hung up these lights in my bathroom so that way I don't have to turn on this light every time because it's so loud and annoying. And so obviously this is not very bright, but for things like just brushing my teeth and going to the bathroom and things like that, I like it because I don't need a ton of light and it's not super loud. So That's nice. I'm gonna listen to some Taylor Swift and get ready, whatever that means. I'm just gonna kind of brush my teeth and stuff. I'm not getting fully like ready with like makeup or anything because one, I don't even wear makeup usually, and two, I have a time slot to go to the gym at 11. We have to book a class or like a time slot to go work out online because there's limited spots available, and we have an hour and a half time slot. So today I have a time slot from 11 to 12:30, so that's why I'm going to the gym. It's kind of nice just because I know that's when I'm going and I can't really back out of it. So that's good, but yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get ready and put on something else besides a sweatshirt and sweatpants. All right, so this is the planner that I'm using for this school year. I got it from Target. And I do really like it. I just don't know how to organize it. Like, I just don't really know the best way to do it. So as you can tell, I like color-coded it by meetings, due dates, tests, quizzes, personal stuff. But I just was kind of trying to write some stuff in for this is the first week and this is the second week. And I just feel like it looks so cluttered and I don't know. It just was kind of stressing me out. So let me know how you guys like organize your written planners, because maybe I'll do it different for September. Should I like color code just based off of the class, or should I keep it like this where it's like specific things and not just separated by class? Then it has the days specifically, so I'm not color coding this, I just kind of wrote it in random colors. But I don't know, I was just like all over the place last night and just trying to write things down as I was seeing them, so I didn't really get to organize it very well. But yeah, I don't really know how this is all gonna work, but I have my two classes, like I said, and then the gym. I'm going to dinner tonight with some friends at the dining hall. And then I need to go to the library, like I said. And I have my lit syllabus. Is like that class is normally on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And that syllabus opens up today, so I'm going to have to look at that. And I have a quiz that opens today that's not due till Friday. My history module opens up. And I have a bunch of other like first week assignments for history, but they're all due on Sunday night, and that's how it's going to be for the whole semester. So everything will open on Monday and then it'll close on Sunday. So that's at least helpful to know that it'll be consistent. So that's kind of how I'm trying to organize this year. If you guys have any tips, please, please comment below, because I really don't know how to do this. It's super confusing with like some classes meeting in person and some not. And I just feel like it's a lot harder to organize and know when assignments are due when I'm not in class, especially since like I'm not in class when they're assigning it and things like that. I've just never had to do this before, so it's kind of stressing me out. But it is like 8:55 right now, so I have like 10 minutes. I think I'm just gonna do it at my desk, honestly. Pretty sure I honestly won't be on there the entire time of this class, just because I feel like it's just gonna be an initial like welcome class thing, so it won't be super long, but we will see. And yeah, that's what's going on. I'm going on to Microsoft Teams right now. About to log in to my class. Yep, it's 8:57 and we're logging in at 9. I've never like used Microsoft Teams before. Like, I'm kind of confused, but it shows on my calendar the two classes that I have. So I have this one at 9. I have no idea how to pronounce her name. I hope she will tell us. And then I have this one at 10. I look great for my first day, don't I? I didn't even bother putting on mascara because there's just no point. But I'm gonna log into class now, and I hope that it goes well.
Because a lot of y'all talked about critical thinking and writing, but one thing I didn't see a lot was communication. And so communication is gonna be in two forms. Outside of just writing, we are gonna be working on...
All right, first class is done. It is 10:03, and I have to log into my second class at 10:10. I'm feeling so tired just from like looking at a computer screen for so long. It wasn't even that long, but... it's just kind of like hard that I'm gonna have to do it back to back. I think I explained to you guys at the beginning of this vlog that I thought that my class that I just went to online was gonna be partly online, but it's actually fully online. So I only have one class that I go to like full time, except for today we're meeting online, which is the one that I'm about to get on. And then I have a class that's on Tuesdays and Thursdays that I will be rotating what day I go. I'm drinking one of these buys, if that's how you say it. Bays? I don't know. B-A-I. It's an antioxidant drink, and I just really feel like I need to get some vitamin C and just being back at school and stuff. And I used to drink like Emergency, but I don't know, these are really refreshing. I really like this flavor. I just started drinking these like the other day because I saw them at the store, and I really like the strawberry lemonade flavor. And there's also a blueberry lemonade that I had the other day that was really good. I'm gonna get on in a few minutes and then go to the gym. I'm really not feeling like working out, but I know once I get there I'll be happy because I love our rec center at the school. So
then Wednesday, or at least Wednesday, I'm planning on being back on campus, so we'll just go from there.
So I just finished both my classes for the day. My 10 o'clock or 10:10 class got out a few minutes early, but I just did a little bit of stretching and it's a little before 11, and I'm gonna head off to the gym now. I'm so excited to work out at this gym again. It's been so long, and I love our rec center, like I was saying earlier. It just has a lot of good equipment, and yeah, I have no idea what it's gonna be like. I know that there's not gonna be as many people that can be in there, obviously, and we have to wear masks and all that, but it'll be interesting to see what they do. I don't know if they have like some equipment blocked off or what, but I'm gonna go ahead and head out. I'm not gonna bring my camera, obviously, but I'm gonna go do that and then come back and make something for lunch. It's required to wear face masks all around campus, so everyone was wearing their face masks. I'm not wearing mine now because I'm literally like walking to my room, but it's very hot, I will tell you that much. So it was a hard workout with the mask on, but glad that we are all doing it. All right, so I started buying a different bread. You guys know I usually love to eat Dave's Killer Bread, but I saw this at Kroger when I was buying groceries and it was a little bit cheaper, so I'm kind of balling on a budget now. So this is the bread that I'm currently using, and then I'm gonna get my egg white cartons, an avocado. I think this one's probably riper, and then I'm just going to like saute up some veggies and stuff. Also, guys, what I did, I'm so proud of myself for doing this. I like chopped up all of my produce that I knew I wanted to use. Well, first of all, I did some sweet potatoes last night, which I'm very excited to have for the week, but I like bought an onion and I chopped it up. It took up two containers, but it's so nice now because I just have these containers ready to use whenever I want to eat it. So it's super handy and I don't have to like cut the vegetables every time I use them. So this is like some red pepper. I have my grapes in there, blueberries, carrots, all that kind of stuff, just to make it easier to grab quickly, and then I have no excuse but to eat it. So I'm excited that I did that. I did it yesterday, so I think Sundays I'll do that and just get things ready for the week. So I'm going to make some avocado toast now, and I can't wait because I'm literally starving. So I am heading out right now to go to Starbucks. I'm gonna do a Grubhub order. We're allowed to order ahead and just go pick it up. So I'm gonna do that, get some coffee, and then I'm going to head to the library, like I said, to print off all my syllabi and go through and highlight them because I just need to have it written down and like me be able to touch it. I don't know, I'm just a very like hands-on person. I do want to show you guys though, something very tragic happened last night. I haven't told you guys yet because I just didn't have a chance to, but basically my car got hit. somebody hit it in the parking lot late last night, and I got a call from our campus police, and I went down there and saw the damage. Luckily, the person did stay, and they did like call the police themselves, which is very nice, and they definitely could have just driven off. They hit me in another car. The other car has worse damage than me, but I definitely still am gonna have to get my bumper replaced, so it's gonna be completely paid for, which is fine. It's just kind of stressful and obviously not ideal by any means, but obviously nothing you can do about it. And like I said, I'm very thankful that the person who hit me didn't just run off, but I'm just walking my car right now to show it to you guys because I'm gonna head that way to get Starbucks. So this is what the damage is looking like. As you guys can tell, the other car that was hit is not next to me anymore, but oh my gosh, my poor car. Literally so sad. Like, it's okay, it's gonna get fixed, but I just cannot believe that happened. So yeah, I show that to you guys because my dad is coming in a couple hours from work to just like look at the car, and we're gonna take it somewhere to get an estimate on how much it'll cost to get it fixed. Obviously the insurance is gonna like deal with all of that, but it's gonna take about a week to get the police report back, which means that I will have about a week before I can get it taken in to get fixed. So obviously it's still drivable, which is good, but just really unfortunate. So sad about that, but I'm gonna go ahead and get my coffee now. Hello guys, it has been a few hours since I talked to you because I had to go with my dad to get an estimate for what it's going to cost to get my car fixed, and we had to get all that squared away, but everything is good now and the insurance is going to take care of it, so that's good. I'm really glad that I got that taken care of. It is a little after 6 now, and I'm going to head to the dining hall with some of my friends, and I'm not sure what it's going to be like. I know that they're definitely taking precautions and things are going to be different, so we're just going to go check it out. They also close at 7, which stinks. Usually they're open till like 9 or 10. And I close at 7, which is like literally in less than an hour. So I head down there and get some food. Hello guys, so it's been a while since I talked to you. I honestly don't know how this vlog has turned out because it's been kind of hard to film throughout the day. But I'm getting ready to go to bed in a few minutes. I went to the dining hall with my friends like I told you guys I was doing, and I got a wrap. One thing that kind of was sad was that they didn't have the little like sandwich presser thing that like warms it up and like toasts the sandwich. And they said that they were gonna have it soon, so I'm not sure like how soon that is, but it was okay. Honestly, I was a little disappointed. They had like paper plates, which was good, you know? So it was just like you throw it away immediately. But I don't know, it just like felt weird in there. They had like all the stations open, but and then I had some of my friends come back to our place and they just hung out for a little bit, and now I'm getting ready to go to bed. So it was definitely a weird first day back to school. It did not really feel like I was back to school because I didn't go to class, obviously. But I was like pretty busy because I went to the gym, went to the library, I spent a while there printing off my syllabus and like highlighting it. And then I had to go get stuff fixed for my car. It was just a pretty busy day, but definitely a very different back to school, first day back to school experience. But I'm glad that I got to document some of it for you guys. I do hope you enjoyed what I did get to film. I'm definitely gonna be doing a lot more college, week of my life, day of my life. So let me know what you wanna see. If you wanna see day of my life or week of my life or a mix of both, just let me know. And also if you guys want to see a completed like dorm room tour, I can do that for you guys too. So thumbs up this video and comment down below what you want to see from me college content wise. I'm gonna try my best to do well this year with vlogging. Things are a lot different this year and I do have roommates, so I'm gonna be like, you know, try to get more comfortable with that. They like, no, I have a YouTube, it's not that big of a deal, but you know, it's sometimes I just want to like be able to like hang out with my friends and not film stuff. So obviously it can be kind of hard to film or to like vlog my days if I'm with my friends a lot. So I don't know, it's gonna take some adjusting, getting used to, so please bear with me and bear with the choppy weird kind of vlogs if there are some like that until I just get into a routine. But I know you guys understand, and let me know down below when you go back to school or if you are going back what you're doing. I'd love to know. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.